Hey everyone, welcome to Altium Academy. I am your host, Zach Peterson, also a technical consultant for Altium. And today we are gonna be looking at a viewer question around the Component Retrace Tool. Mark Workman writes, how? Mark, I feel your pain. Sometimes these features can be a little difficult to use. Sometimes the activation is a little buried. I'm gonna show you exactly how to access this tool, how to activate it, and some of the best practices for using the tool when you need to do some kind of component rearrangement. With that in mind, let's get started. Okay, so I'm gonna start out inside our newly familiarized differential pairs redo layout. I used this layout in a different video on rerouting differential pairs. And there are those times in your journey through PCB design where you will need to take some of these components and maybe move them around a little. And there are various reasons for doing that. But let's just suppose for a moment that you need to move around some of these components and you want to minimize your rerouting time. How do you do this? Normally, if I were to say, take these two components and move them down like this, I'm gonna have to go through and reroute these traces. Depending on the components you move, that can be really difficult. So just for example, we've got this integrated circuit here. If I take this and I move it around, you notice that it doesn't actually fill in any of the routing for me, even if this component was completed using the interactive or the auto route tools or any of the other automation tools in Altium Designer. Well, one tool you can use to speed up your design process is the Component Retrace Tool. So to access the Component Retrace Tool, all you need to do is go into the Preferences section in the top right portion of the main screen in Altium Designer, go down to PCB Editor, go to Interactive Routing, and then turn on Component Reroute. Now, once you've turned this on, something very interesting will happen once you pick up a component and move it. If I take this component and move it over like this, you see that it then fills in the space with traces. So it essentially finishes that route for me. So that's actually really useful. And I can even pick this big block of components. I can move it down like this. And the auto route engine is gonna do its best to then rebuild all of these connections. Now you have to be careful here because look on this example. This example filled in the SPI clock line here going to this bottom resistor. The problem is that it left over this little stub right here. So this is some rework that we would have to do and basically just select it and shorten it or just delete it entirely. So this is just an example of some of the movements that you can do with a bunch of components. Something important to note, let's say this particular resistor right here, I pick this guy up and I move it over like this. Well, when I make that movement, you notice that it does fill in the 1V8 trace. So it actually does eliminate the extra trace that's left over. However, you'll notice here that R11 pin 2, so this lower pad, actually doesn't get rerouted. That's because this section of copper is actually a region. So this is defined as a region and it is not going to automatically redraw that copper connection to fill in that space and restore the connection back to this pad. So in that case, it'd actually be better to already have this routed with traces before you lay down this region of copper, because then this region of copper is going to persist here and you may need to redraw it anyways, regardless if you use the Component Retrace Tool or not. But then what can happen is if you then just move this back, you notice that it eliminates that section of trace that was here. It is not going to redraw those polygons or those fill regions, but it will redraw any traces that are connected to them. So that allows you to do things like this where I can move around this resistor and it's gonna continue to fill this in. And if I make some kind of change like this, you'll notice here I can just select this region, I can drag it out, and I can continue to fill this region in and eventually redraw that, that copper fill just the way I had it before, or at least pretty close. Let's just say for a moment that I want to pick up this big block of resistors and I want to move it around. I could take this entire block and move it like I did before, and the Component Retrace Tool will, you know, fill in all of these gaps and make and restore these connections. What if I want to move not just the components, but also some of these trace sections too? So like, for example, let's say I want to move these components, these sets of tracks, and also the via that's right here connecting to this resistor. So I can also do that. And when I do that, it can be kind of tough. And obviously this layout is difficult because you can see here, it's pretty tight. I've got a differential pair here. But if you make those kinds of movements, it will also try and restore all of those connections that you have selected. So let's say, for example, I select all of these components and this big trace section, these vias, this trace section, and this big resistor up here. If I then move this around, you'll notice that it is also going to try and restore those connections back to those pads, and it'll preserve the connectivity in all of the objects that I selected. Now, within the larger component like this integrated circuit, it can be a little tough. Sometimes you will have to eliminate some of this routing in order for the connections to then get restored automatically. So if I take this big integrated circuit, and let's say I move it down like this, what you'll then find is it'll do its best to try and restore all of those connections and to eliminate any of the leftover stubs that occur when these connections are restored. But in this case, because you've got so many different connections that are made here, and this is already a really dense layout, there might be some rerouting there as well. So next, I want to look at this big connector down here. So you'll see with this big connector, we've got a lot of stuff coming off of here, right? We've got some vias coming off and going to ground. We've got some differential pairs coming off. We've got some other signals that are single-ended that are coming off of here. This is a bunch of SPI lines coming off here in the middle of these two rows of, or these two columns of pads. Moving this big connector is actually pretty common. It's common that you may find after you're done with the design that you do actually need to relocate a connector slightly in order to ensure that you're going to hit your mechanical requirements. So even with this big connector like this, you know, we can still pick this up and move it. So if I take this and move it off like this, you're going to notice that there's a lot of tracks that get rerouted coming back into these pads. So this is an example where once the component retrace tool finishes, there are some leftover broken connections here that you'll then need to manually move. So be careful with how far you try and move some of this stuff, because you know, when you have a big dense connector like this and you then try to move it around without changing anything else, you're probably going to introduce routing discontinuities that are going to be difficult to fill in with the auto route tool. But small movements of these bunches of components like this, those are really useful, and those are the kind of things that the auto route engine can then fill back in as part of component retracing. So the last thing I want to go over with this tool, which is really important, is design rules. When you move something around, you could then have a design rule violation that results once the rerouting is filled in. After you do a component retrace and move around any of those components, make sure that you run a design rule check. Some of those design rule checks you'll actually see flash on the screen, so you'll be able to see them visually. But you should still run a design rule check just to ensure that you haven't created any new errors in the design through that component retracing. So the last example I want to look at is kind of a typical example where you might want to use the component retrace tool to really easily move stuff around. Let's just suppose, for example, we need to move this particular component out of the way of something. I don't know what it is, but something. This particular component is a buck regulator, so I think it would make sense to actually just pick all of this stuff up and move it all together. Well, what you can do is, by moving around this big section of circuitry, it's actually going to be really easy to then restore some of these connections back into this circuit when you make these moves. So if I just modify my selection filter here, pick up all of this stuff, and then I go ahead and move this, I'll then be able to restore a lot of these connections automatically with the component retrace tool. You can see here, this makes it really easy to pick up this big group of components and tracks and regions and everything else and move this wherever you want. And you can see here, it just automatically restores these connections. So that's very useful, big time saver. I like to use it when I have to do these kind of group of component moves, and give it a try and see how well it works in your workflow. All right, everyone. So that wraps up our intro to the component retrace tool. This tool is very useful. Just be careful about how you use it, because it does have to fill in routing using the auto routing engine. I know auto routers have a little bit of a bad name associated with them, and they do require some cleanup sometimes, but this is one of those great efficiency tools in Altium Designer. So give it a shot, come up with your own strategies for using it, and have fun. Thanks again for watching, everybody. Make sure to hit that like button, hit the subscribe button, leave your comments and questions in the comments section. And last but not least, don't forget to call your fabricator, folks.